No food for next 40 days. No gum, no candy of any kind, no mints, nothing, just water for that whole time. Also, I'm going to be keeping record of how many times I go to the bathroom, how many bottles of water I drink. This little baby here, the wallet, anytime I'm left alone, without supervision around, there to take my wallet. Whoever's near me, that I know, not just somebody. I can never be alone with my wallet and with access to money.
Yeah. Oh yeah. It feels so bad eating in front of Kenny. But it has to be done.
It looks obviously feel very bad about it. Is there a
problem? No, you're done with that crust? Yeah, I know.
Never thought I'd get so tired of water.
Over the years that I've gotten to know my Persian friends and their culture, what I've really noticed is how mealtime is their bonding time. They cook together, they eat together. Their connection with food has a whole different meaning. It seems like here in America, we're so caught up in our fast-paced lives that we've forgotten how important these family traditions are. Sure, it's easier to just hit the drive-thru and call that dinner, but think about what we're sacrificing.
So because you cannot eat, I don't want to insult the host.
So he's gonna take care of that problem.
Thanks, yeah.
Kenny, we'll see you in about 31 days.
Very bad, huh?
It's actually the first time I've been hungry. No.
I've got one.
I'm here to show you guys how to barbecue hot dog. I do know barbecue hot dog comes from Iran.
Well, last time I checked, Iran's not known for their barbecue, but Texas is.
That's right. 30 days of fasting is trying to prove you could do it. It's barbecue for everybody, but he's not going to eat it.
Oh, it feels good to even touch food.
Mm-hmm. Is that the first time you touched food?
It is.
Feels good. These dudes are like the best hot dogs I've ever seen. So I was sitting there the other day and I thought, I was just curious. I said, well, I gotta figure out, I wanna see who, cause there's gotta be a world record for fasting, right?
Yeah.
And so I just decided to go look online. So I went and typed in, looked online, and I saw that apparently David Blaine, when he hung up in the Times Square thing, you know, he did it for 44 days. So some Russian dude did it last year. And for 50 days, and so that's when I was like, well, you know what? They can do. I'm doing it 40 days. I'm doing pretty good. Why the crap not go?
Yeah.
For 55, just try to get the world record. You know, be kind of cool getting the Guinness Book of World Records.
Yeah.
That'd be neat. I thought the fast was supposed to turn me off to like greasy stuff and looking, but man, this food looks delicious, man. Oh, it smells so good. Man, that's a lot of hot dogs. Man. And I can't have any of them.
Corn and potatoes together. That's good. At least in Texas, right?
Yeah, there is. Yeah, the mashed potatoes good. They look good too. Everything looks good.
Cajun rice. Yeah, and on top of it, check it out. Check it out. Jambalaya chicken grilled.
Food is everywhere. On TV, in movies, and magazine ads, I see it everywhere I go. I just can't escape it. The temptations are overwhelming, especially with the smell of food cooking all around me. Now, with Jeremy taunting me, it's enough to make me want to run out the front door, find the first fast food place I see, and order half the menu. Food is like heroin to me. My mouth waters as I envision eating all that greasy food. I mean, it's an addiction that's so hard to overcome because no matter what, you have to eat to live.
Dinner is served. Round two.
I'm so close to finishing, I just have to hang in there. talking about my breakup was really tough. I've been pushing it to the back of my mind for so long that finally facing it was actually a release. Losing her had such an impact on me. It completely changed the way I dealt with my emotions. That's something I need to work on if I'm going to change the way I deal with pain in the future. I just can't keep running to food any longer.
And so, mark down. This is the fourth time I've gone to the bathroom today, because I'm going to the bathroom right now. And I'm going to be talking about something that Dr. Galley told me to go pick up. These things, they're keto sticks. You pee on the little end thing and then you got to correlate it with the side here. This tells you if your body has gone into ketosis or not, which this means nothing, and this means you're heavily into ketosis. It's ketosis time. Woo! And as we see here, let's see, the ketone strip didn't change really any color. It changed that color, which means it's negative, which means my body has not even started in ketosis yet. Pretty natural, I guess. It wouldn't expect me to be instantly into ketosis from not eating for one day. So there we go. Should I collect these, you think?
I used to love to go for a run, especially on a day like this, but I gradually became embarrassed and self-conscious about my body, so I eventually stopped. You know, it takes a lot of courage and self-confidence for a person to just not care about what other people may think or what they might say and just go out there and do the things normal people do. Now I'm more embarrassed by the fact that I cared that much to let it stop me for that long.
I do cardiac and pulmonary. Over the years, things that you've seen that we're eating, how we're eating, things such as this. I'm a firm believer that you can damn near eat anything that you want. It's what you do after. I still feel it's input. I think it's exercise. And also, I think a lot of it comes back to psychological. There is a criteria that states when gastric bypass should be done clinically. We are doing them now in 13 and 14-year-old kids. When you have a kid 13, 14, that's weighing 325 pounds, you've got a problem. Gastric bypass should only be for those that psychologically cannot handle their weight. In other words, obesity is not a reason to have a gastric bypass. It's very simple. What goes in comes out.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Unless you have glandular trouble. And that's right. 1/10% of people that have weight problems.
People come in all sorts of shapes and sizes, but only a small percentage actually have some sort of medical reason they're overweight. As for everyone else, it's mainly due to their emotional eating, lifestyle habits, or both. Ask any of them why they think they're overweight, they're going to tell you they're big bone, it's genetics, or something like that. Now, ask those same people what size their great-grandparents were, their great-great-grandparents, and I bet they'll tell you they were all average sized. Ask anyone over 65 how many obese people they remember seeing as a child, and they'll tell you there were very, very few. At my breaking point, I'm physically, emotionally, and spiritually exhausted. How much longer can I keep doing this? I'm almost at the end of it, or I would be, but now I'm trying to break a world record?
I'm way into the whole fast now. I mean, I'm nearing on, I don't know, 30-something days. You lose count after a while, even though I keep track of it all. But today I went out with Jeremy and Elena, and we played tennis. I was so exhausted that when I got back, I just crashed out. I just took a shower and laid down and just been like, blah. I mean, I could barely even walk up the stairs here. I'm so tired. You know, I vomited, and I'm like, what's there to vomit? I've got nothing in my stomach. I'm like, you know, and it was weird because it was like pink. Like, I guess it was just stomach acid is all I did. But so that's a word of caution out there. I gotta make sure not to go crazy like that anymore. I need to really be careful because, you know, it hit me today. I said, man, I've done, I gotta be careful in the exercise.
What am I doing? Have I lost sight of my goal? Is going for the world record really more important to me than my health, than my well-being? What am I trying to prove to myself?